Hi there, this is Brett Bliet from Simplified Courses, and today we will learn how to optimize conditional validators with Angular forms. In the last video, we saw how easy it was to set up validators with vest suites and to set up conditional validators. The password is required and the confirm password is required only when there is a password. When there is no password, it's not required anymore. We have two form controls. We have the password form control, and we have the confirm password form control. An expectation would be that when the password form control changes, that the validators of confirm password form control are also executed. So when password form control updates, confirm password form control would update as well. Now in reality, when password form control updates, the confirm password form control does not. That makes sense because when the password changes, it triggers the ng-model or ng-model group and execute the validation function of the password control. For the confirm password, nothing changes, so nothing triggers, so no validations are being executed. And the other way around, confirm password changes, it triggers ng-model or ng-model group, updates the validate function, and again for the password now nothing is being triggered. Now in the previous video, we learned how to use the always trigger validations input property of the form directive, and then every time something changed, all the validators of our entire form were executed. That's nice for a POC, but it's not really performant, especially when we're going to use asynchronous validators, which is something that I will show in the next video. So let's try to find a better solution on when to execute the right validators at the right time. Let's start by creating a validation config object. Which has its key string and it holds an array of strings. When the age would change, we would also want to trigger the emergency contact. When passwords.password changes, we want to trigger the validations of passwords.confirmPassword. Let's dive a little deeper in our form directive. We can see that we already have an always trigger validations setter that would always trigger the validations, which is not what we want. So let's add a new input called validation config. Let's loop over the keys of our object. And for each key, we want to listen to changes. So let's listen to the changes of our form, map it to the right value, and we'll use a distinct little changed operator from RxJS to only get notified when there is a real change, so when a validator should be executed. Let's make sure we don't have any memory leaks. Let's subscribe to the result. And every key had an array of strings, remember? Those were the validators, or at least the controls that the validators have to run from. So let's get that path and use the update and validity function from Angular. We set only self to true and we don't want to emit an event. Now let's use our new validation config. First of all, we don't want to trigger validations all the time anymore, so let's remove this and replace it with the validation config. Works like a charm. Awesome! We have fixed a huge issue today. Before, all our validators were running all the time. Every time a control changed, all the validators were running, and right now we have a nice and clean configuration object where we can say this specific control, if that one changes, then these controls, their validators have to change as well. I hope you enjoyed this. I will see you next week for our asynchronous validators in Angular Vest Suites video. If you like this content, please subscribe. Stay awesome. Cheers. Before I forget, my Getting Extremely Productive with Angular Forms course is finished. You can check it out at simplified.courses/forms. I open source the entire solution for you. If you're eager to get more, I also have this awesome content. Thank you. Cheers.